Welcome back to our ongoing series on creating an e-commerce remix application. Today I'll be doing something special, and that's adding a database to the project. So I've been spending some time thinking about it, and I couldn't decide between SQLite and Postgres, and I've decided to go with Postgres. The reason behind it is that I want some feature support that's not available in SQLite. I'll probably be storing arrays in the database, and I also want enum support so I can show you some cool tricks with Zod and enums. So for now I'll go with Postgres, and it also works nice with Supabase, which I plan to use to store images. So I've decided to go with Postgres for now. If I run into a situation where I don't want to use Postgres, I'll keep you noted, but for now we'll be moving forward with Postgres, and the ORM we're gonna use is Prisma. So without further ado, let's add Prisma to our project using Postgres as a database. The first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go to Prisma, which looks really nice today, and we're gonna click on the Get Started here. And as you can see, it has a Get Started section that explains how to start it up. And we're going to be working with Postgres, so we're going to click that. And the first thing we need from the docs is the command here, so the npx prisma init. We're going to copy it, and we're going to go back to our project. And inside of here, we're going to run it. And now let's see what it generated. So if we scroll up, you can see that it generated the Prisma schema, and it tells us what to do next. So the next steps are to set the database URL, to set the provider in the schema Prisma file, and to run these two commands. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna open the schema Prisma here, and as you can see, it's already set to Postgres, so we don't really have to do anything here. So let's set up our database. So before we do anything else, there's something important that we need to keep in mind. There are two bundles inside of Remix. The first bundle is the server bundle that bundles everything that's on the server, and then there's the client bundle that bundles everything on the client. So from Vite, what we can do is we can use the .server convention and create a .server file, and inside that file store everything that's going to be on the server. So the first thing we're gonna do is add a db.ts file, and because it's in .server, this will only get bundled on the server. So if you don't already know, Remix has a convention where if you add a .server.ts to a file name, it's going to be bundled only on the server. If you want it to be bundled only on the client, you would do something like entry.client.ts. And this tells Remix where to bundle it, either on the server or on the client. If it doesn't have this, so if it's entry.ts, it's going to be bundled into both bundles. But the cool thing is, because this is in a .server file and this works only in Vite, it's going to be bundled only on the server. So why do we do that? Because we don't want to send this to the client, because on the client this would break, because you can't initialize Prisma on the client. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a Prisma client, and we're just gonna import it here from Prisma. And because we don't have this installed, let's install it. And we'll also install Prisma as a dev dependency. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a Prisma instance with the client, and then we're gonna export it. One thing to keep in mind is, because we initialize the Prisma client on line 3, whenever this file gets imported somewhere, it's going to run this and then export it. And if you import it through a barrel file or you import it somewhere, it will run as a side effect. And what this means is, if you import it, for example, in your root TSX, and let's say you export some sort of barrel file where you export both the database and something that's supposed to be used on the client, something like a string modifier, you need to be very careful not to export everything from barrel files. So the best thing you can do is avoid using barrel files at all costs. It's better to have more imports than have more barrel files, and also barrel files can cause huge issues with bundle sizes because they can bundle everything by mistake, so it's really good to avoid them. Now that we've initialized the database, we can use it here. Before we actually use it, I'll have to set up a few different things, but something I want to show you first is if we import Prisma from database, so it's going to be like this. package.server/db. So why does this not cause issues on the client, even though it's a side effect import? And let's say we use it inside of our loader, something like this. So for now, we don't really care. Why does this work without breaking? How Remix bundles code is, it takes the loader, and let's say we have an action as well. We're gonna delete it later on, but let's add it for now just to show my point. Let's say you have a loader and then an action, and you import this as a side effect, and it doesn't crash the client. So the reason behind this is if you use it, for example, here, or you use it somewhere in the action, so something like Prisma user find many here, how the code gets bundled is Remix removes the action and the loader, and then is going to remove everything that's not used, that's an import. And you can even exclude the types because the types don't get bundled. And what you're gonna be left with is basically this. So we don't use anything from the server here, and this gets bundled on the client. So that's the reason why it works as a side effect, even though it's imported in the same file where the client code is. And now that if we go back here, we're gonna remove the section, we're gonna move Prisma for now, and we're just gonna leave it here and save this. And the next thing we need to do is we need to actually create a database. What I'm gonna do is I'm going to create a database on Supabase. So basically what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create a new project on Supabase. When I create the project, I'm going to go to project settings, and in there you're gonna be able to find your Postgres database URL. I'm not gonna show it to you, but basically you're gonna go to the dot environment, and here instead of this one, you're gonna paste it in and replace it so you can connect to your database. After you've done that, you're gonna come back to the project, and let's add a few things to our scripts here. The first thing we're gonna add is DB gen. So what this is gonna do is it's going to run Prisma generate, and basically what this does is it generates the types from your Prisma client. When you open up the schema here and you add models here, when you run Prisma generate, it generates the TypeScript types for you. So we're gonna be doing that later on, but for now we don't have any types, but basically this command will generate these types for us. The second command I'm gonna add is db migrate, and we're gonna run Prisma migrate dev. This will migrate the migrations inside of our Prisma file. We haven't created it yet, but we'll do it very soon. The third command is db seed, and that's going to be Prisma DB seed. And this will run the seed script and seed our database. And the last thing is DB studio, and this will open up Prisma studio for us. And what I'm gonna do is I'm going to wrap this one and this one in npm run script. We're gonna escape twice, and then we're gonna paste these commands in, and we're gonna add confirm here. So what this will do is, if you watched part 2, this will allow us to basically run the seed command, but first we will need to confirm that we want to run it. So if I run npm run db seed, as you can see, it's going to tell us we're gonna load the dev environment from dot environment, and we're about to execute the script in the dev environment, and are we sure? So we need to confirm to execute it. So for now we'll say no. And this allows you to basically make sure that you confirm it before you run it, because if you see the database by accident, that's not a good thing. So better to be careful. And that's it for the script parts. And the last thing we're gonna do is, we're inside of the Prisma folder, we're gonna create a seed.ts file. And inside of here, we want to create a seed script that's going to seed our database when we want it to. So this is pretty simple. So what we need to do here is we're gonna import the Prisma client again. We're gonna create a new Prisma client, and then we'll create an async function called main. Here we'll do something like this. We will change this later on, but for now let's leave it like this, and we close it, and then we run this. And instead of throwing here, we're gonna change it to a console log, or rather console error. We're gonna exit, and we'll also say that it failed. And what we're gonna do when this runs is say console log, see successful. And what we can do is make it a little bit prettier. So we're gonna import shock, we're gonna say green, and we're gonna say see it successful here and save that. And now we're gonna clear the console. And first thing we need to do is create the migration. So we're gonna do yarn db migrate. Before you run this command, make sure that you've added the database URL to your .environment file. And as you can see, we tried to connect, but we don't have any models yet. So let's add a model for now. And it asks us for a name of the migration. So we'll say add users table, or actually create users table. And we created the migrations folder, as you can see, and this creates a migration lock as well. We've created this migration. And now we want to seed our database. So we're gonna run npm run db seed. We're gonna confirm it. We're gonna copy this and then paste it in. And the last thing we need to add is this to the package.json. We're gonna do it at the end here. And now if we run the command and confirm it, we've successfully seeded the database. And now if I clear this and run npm run db studio, and if we go to the browser, we're gonna see that we've created our first user with the email and the name that we created. All right, and now if we go back to the VS Code, and if we go to our root ESX here, and let's do this. So const user is equal to Prisma user find first. And let's just console log this and save it. And now let's stop Prisma Studio and clear this and then run npm run dev. You can see that we've fetched our user from the database correctly. And I had two tabs of Remix open, that's why it's logged twice. As you can see, it's working. And it didn't crash because, as we said, it's not bundled together on the client and it's only in the server, so we're good to go. We have our database up and running. If we go to the package.json, we have our type generation script here, we have our migration script, we have our seeding script, and we have our studio script. This is more than enough to start working with Prisma efficiently. And the last thing I want to show you is the Prisma generate stuff I was talking about earlier. So if we go here, for example, let's say we want to type this as a user type. We're just gonna do this and say user. And as you can see, I can import it from the Prisma slash client. And this is what I was talking about earlier, that the Prisma generates types. So these are basically type safe definitions for your database. And this is a really useful tool to be able to work with Prisma, because you can easily define custom types with it and do a lot of cool things. And we'll do that in the near future. But for now, just for the demonstration purpose, this is enough. We're gonna delete this and we're gonna save it. And for now, that's it. I have shown you how to set up a database using Prisma, and in the next video I'll show you how to run integration tests with this and how you can test your models and do a lot of cool stuff, and how you can create factories to help you run integration tests smoothly and have a great developer experience with it. If you have any questions for this one, feel free to leave them in the comments down below. If you enjoyed the video, consider liking it and sharing it with others. And if you like the series, consider subscribing. And that's it for today. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one. Bye!